Welcome, mindful parents. In today's video, I'm sharing 5 notes about anger in a life of a parent. The first tip about anger is that it's unavoidable. It's like weather. We have sunny days, and the next day might be a cloudy day or a rainy day. We cannot expect to have sunny days all the time. It's very natural. Anger is part of life, and we all experience anger at some point, like experiencing different seasons and different weather. Tip number 2. Anger is like a warning signal, a flashing red light, letting us know that there's something that is going on, not with our child, but within ourselves. Sometimes it might be something that was triggered from childhood memory, something that we've encountered as children, and now it's coming up. We cannot always explicitly pinpoint that, but it could be unconsciously brought up with our behavior. Another reason why it is a red signal or a flashing red light, imagine that you're in a car and your fuel is running low. Your gas signal will start flashing. That means you need to go and fuel your car. It's like fueling yourself too. You have been maybe too busy. You have overfilled your plate with so many different things that anything that can happen or one more thing on that plate is going to make you angry. You will not be able to handle it. So it's a flashing red light for you to stop and notice that what is going on. Maybe I have pushed myself a little bit too much. Tip number 3 that you need to keep in mind when you get angry is that move away. Stop what you're doing and move away. Try to self-regulate. Tip number 4 is after you have stopped and calmed yourself down is to deconstruct what caused that anger. You can ask questions like, is it something that triggered me from my childhood upbringing? Is it that I have overfilled my plate with so many things to do? Pause and we deconstruct why we got angry, it helps us learn and grow, and we become better at calming ourselves down next time. We are able to notice before we get angry. We stop ourselves before we get to that stage. Number 5. If you did get angry, and let's say you yelled at your children, you need to go and repair, heal that relationship, that incident with your child. This means you go back to your child and say that I'm sorry that I was yelling. I was not able to control my own emotions. Never say that you made me angry, because it is you who are in control of your emotions and how to self-regulate. Be transparent about it and talk to your child. This will teach your child how we all do mistakes. It's a great example to teach your children that when we do mistakes, we go back and we fix it. It is so important to know and understand that anger is part of being a human. We all get angry. But what is important is for us to notice when we get angry and maybe stop ourselves before we actually reach that point. And if we do get angry, that we calm ourselves down, that we reflect and see why we got angry and repair if we caused some damage.